Yes.
Okay, hi all. In the next few minutes, I'm going to discuss about the topic called one-shot hypothesis derivation and its application in the area of image processing. First, I convey my gratitude towards all my co-authors. So here is just an overview of my presentation. So I try to accommodate the concept from human-like computing in the method which I'm going to propose. So as we all know, humans learn from background knowledge. We have titled our algorithm as one-shot hypothesis derivation since it can learn from a single positive example. So then I have developed two applications using one-shot hypothesis derivation, one for character recognition and another one to detect dementia-like diseases, neurological diseases from retinal images. Then later I will present the results in terms of comparison with a deep learning architecture. So we have developed one-shot hypothesis derivation as a special case of top-directed hypothesis derivation. The main property of OSHD, one-shot hypothesis derivation, is its declarative bias. So declarative bias means a logic program over the hypothesis space, which helps to decide the structure of our hypothesis. The main use of this declarative bias is that it can help us to make a bias or differentiate from one problem to another, like a transfer learning. And also it helps to reduce the search space for hypothesis derivation. So here, I'm explaining the mathematical model of our system. We have five inputs, like predicate symbols represented by NT, and a declarative bias, it's a top theory, and background knowledge, E, and the most important input is like we are using only single positive example, and our system would generate hypothesis which cover one of the positive example. So here I'm trying to explain while combining the top theory, the declarative bias and single positive example, we can prove that our hypothesis is correct using SLD refutation, it's a representation. So our algorithm contains three steps, like using refutation, as I shown before, we will generate all the hypothesis as a generalization of a single positive example, which is represented by E. And we will calculate the coverage of each hypothesis, which is a generalization of a single example. Then we will try to maximize the coverage function. So in our system, we are using compression as a coverage function. We can also add or give weight to the examples. Then we can redefine the compression-based evaluation function. So as I told earlier, we have applied this OSHD concept in two different domains. One is character recognition. So we have adapted a language from India, which is known as Malayalam. The reason for selecting those languages is like we don't have any efficient algorithm for Malayalam handwritten character recognition because of its large number of alphabets and different writing styles and different structures and similarity in shapes. As you can see here, these are two different alphabets, but if you are considering the structure, it may predict that it is same. Then we have followed a human-like feature extraction. So we have decided around six high-level features, like as you can see in the right side, loop, junction, arc, starting and ending point. So as you can see here, if you compare the first letter and the last letter, we can see that there are two loops in the first letter, but there is only one in the second letter. So just we have applied high level feature extraction method. The important property is we have to consider the starting point and ending point. So as a native user, someone if it is a native user, it is very very easy to understand where the stroke of alphabets start and where the stroke of alphabets end. But like a foreign user, it is very difficult to understand the starting and ending point. That's why we have used or we have incorporated starting and ending point as a features for character recognition. The second application is like neurological diagnosis detection. So nowadays, recent studies shows that if we are using retinal images, we can easily identify or easily detect Alzheimer's and Parkinson's like diseases. So this method is very useful because it is non-invasive and it is cheap. Like also we can keep to perform like. So then we have collected our data set from UK Biobank. And as I said earlier, we have followed some feature extraction, human-like feature extractions. So here we have used some image processing techniques and we have selected different set of features as you can see in the table. And these features depends upon the radius from the optic center of the retinal images. As you can see here, there are three different regions notated as A, B, and C. So these features depends on the location where it lies. And as you can see here, we have followed four different steps. So as I shown in the previous slide, it is very important to detect the optic center. So optic disc localization is the important step during the feature extraction. We have followed some matching mechanisms to detect the optic disc. And the second stage is like classification of artery and veins. For that, we have used some deep learning architecture, deep learning models to classify the veins like artery and vein. Then we have extracted those features, which is mentioned in the previous slide. And using some encoding mechanisms, we have encoded the data set and represented as a background knowledge. So you can see the background knowledge representation as an encoding of those features, which I explained in the previous slide. And as I said earlier, OSHD use a declarative bias, which is in the form of mod H and mod B. So mod H represents the head of the hypothesis, which we are going to learn. Then mod B represents the literals, which may appear in the body of the hypothesis rule. So like here, I'm explaining a deep learning architecture, which I have used for comparison purpose. So this architecture is known as Siamese network. As the name indicates, it contains two parallel networks, which is particularly developed for one-shot learning. So it contains two parallel networks with same properties in terms of weight layers. Then we will use some energy function to provide some predictions. During the experiments, we have selected 46 alphabets, different types of alphabets from Malayalam character, which is from the OmniGlot dataset. And each alphabet contains 20 images. Regarding the neurodegenerative dataset, we have selected four disease categories like dementia, Parkinson's disease, and Alzheimer's disease, along with healthy data. We have developed some human cognitive features, as I explained, using retinal image and characters. We have developed those features. The important thing is that we have reiterated the same concept of working in both architecture, that's in both in OSHD as well as in Siamese network. So we have followed cross-validation. In each fold, we will consider single positive example and n negative examples. So I will explain it during the result. So this is the result. So as result indicates, for the character recognition task, we have used one positive, but different number of. So x-axis indicates different number of negative examples. So The first point indicates that we have used only one positive and one negative. This point 6 indicates we have used only one positive and 6 negatives during the learning process. So it is very evident that OSHD, it's an ILP approach, outperforms Siamese network deep learning architecture. The reason behind this outperformance is that we don't have much data, both in character recognition and retinal images. We don't have much data. So if data is not more, then it's obvious that deep learning will not perform well. So these are the some learned rules from both character recognition process and neurological diagnosis process. So as a conclusion, like this is a new approach for one-shot learning. One-shot learning is very important if we don't have much data to learn. Even deep learning will not help us during that stage. So we have developed our system in terms for one-shot learning using declarative bias. As we discussed, we could successfully apply OSHD for this image processing task, along with a human visual cognized data set. And from the learned rules, which is in the previous slide, you can see that it's natural and visually acceptable. Also, it outperforms deep learning architecture. Okay, thank you. Any queries?